Hi, and welcome to my channel at Bunny Hollow Crafts. Excuse my cough. I will do a tutorial for the little quick and easy baby album. These are for our base pages. You'll need 3 pages that are 8x6. You'll need 3 that are 7x6. And you'll need 4 little flaps that are 6¼x6¼. Okay, if you want to write that down. 8x6, 7x6, 6¼x6¼. 4 of these, 3 each of these. So let's score our 8x6s. We're going to turn them on our side and score it 1/2 inch top and bottom, or either end, whichever way you want to call it. There's 1. There. Okay, now you need to fold and burnish your score lines and put on score tape. I'm gonna have to open up another pack of score tape. I've used all my, is it 3/8 inch, 7/8, 3/8, I guess it is. Anyway, let me grab a pack of that and then we'll put score tape on and we'll put our pages together. I got a new roll of score tape. I'm going to put score tape on the edges. And this really is very quick and very simple. And it would work for about any kind of little mini album you wanted to make. But I just thought, since this is not for the mother, it's the grandmother, just having the little months go quicker, you know, she'll enjoy that, I hope. I mailed it today to her, so. Take your 7x6s and pokey tool, release your tape. If these things don't match up, I will trim. I had that problem. I started filming the camera wasn't rolling. So this one too looks like it's, you know, it's even at the bottom, but it's short at the top. I cut these with my guillotine trimmer and I cut all the papers at once, but I'm gonna go back and trim that, and I'll do all 3 pages together. That's what I did previously. There's some tape hanging over. I'm gonna push that back. So just push your hand, you don't want a bubble in the middle, and pull your tape. And so we're even on the bottom. I'll just go and trim, and it'll probably be, as it was earlier, every page was like that. So I don't know. I don't really care for the little guillotine trimmer. The marks aren't real well marked, I guess. But anyway, I will just bring this one down to the bottom, and that way I'll only have one end to trim. Okay. Come on. There's 2, and let's do the third one. It'll probably be the exact same if I had to guess. I'll put it on towards the bottom, matching up the bottom edge. Have one edge perfect. Yep, it's the exact same. So I will cut all 3 of them. Well, I want to cut them all at the same time. I tried that with my guillotine, it wouldn't do it. So I'll do it with my X-Acto knife. That's the way to do it. Okay, so burnish your tapes really well. And I'm sorry mine are crooked, not crooked, just off a little bit, but if that ever happens to you, this, you'll know how to do it now. So I'm going to use my X-Acto knife and my ruler, and I'm just going to put it on a line so I know it's straight at the top. And I'm just going to take off a scant little, I mean, it's nothing, it's less than 1/8, but I will feel better about it. I don't want that little tiny overhang. It's not a good look. But that is quick and easy, and that got it perfectly. So that's how I'll do mine. If you can see, it's just a little bit, See? And that comes from that. I'm not going to use that guillotine trimmer for this anymore. But it's easily rectified. Doesn't like to trim up there where the tape is. That's the thickest part. Okay, so let's just check them. Yeah, they're all the same. All right, so let's get going with flaps. Let me clean up my mess. We need our scoreboard to score these. These are a square, so it really doesn't matter. I'm just gonna score a half an inch on all four of them. Okay, don't need the scoreboard anymore. Let's fold and burnish those. What is on my paper? Just cleaned up from making that album. I've got messes everywhere. The score well. We'll put these on. I did it with glue and it seemed to work very well. Okay, let me grab my pages and we'll put them together. My pages and my flips, and hopefully my glue will work. Look at that, tip came all the way off. Better work. I tried to unclog it today, and if not, we'll just go without the fine metal tip. Flips are right here. Please come out. I've been nice to you. Be nice to me. I look at you. Okay. Okay, so just snug it up to the side, put it in the middle. You could actually put it wherever you wanted. You could put it on this side. You could put it at the top. I'll show you with this one. So you'd have to trim it a little more. You'd have to trim that off. But you could put it at the top if you wanted top folding. You could also put it there. But I put all mine on the right or the left side. So. Okay, so that's one on each side of that page. Bring in another one and put one on each side of this page. And then the other thing I had in there was a belly band and a waterfall. So let's stick that on there. And flip it over and put on the last one. Okay, so that's both of the last two pages done with a flip on both sides. Now here's our last page. Let me pull out a scrap to make a belly band. Hold on one sec. I pulled out a scrap. I always use my scraps. This one is, looks like it's 11 inches long. Maybe this one from 12 by 12, but it's about two and a quarter. But all I'm gonna do is score, and this is a belly band, so I scored an inch on mine. Because, you know, they kind of get wear and tear. And then I'm going to put this in here. And I'm just going to make a mark up here where I need to score. Somewhere right in there. So I'll put that at any number and just score and fold. And then I'll cut this flap off. We don't need all that flap. Okay, so here's the page. I will tell you, I did not put mine on. Mine was a hair shorter than this, so you could see the paper underneath. This one is almost to the exact length the page, so I'm going to go ahead and put it on. The reason I didn't is you want to get your pattern paper under there, but I don't think it's going to be a problem with this. But if that's a concern for you, put your pattern paper on there or mat it. I matted mine. I think it turned out really cute matted. And just turn it to the side. I always put mine top to bottom because I find when you put your things in there sideways like that, they stay in. When you put the belly band one that way, I know it's probably not going to fall out, but it's just what I think of in my mind. So just burnish that down really well and down on that side. And then let's make a waterfall, and that's what went on this side. So let me grab my supplies. Okay, to cut your waterfall, I'm just using 8.5 by 11. I'm going to cut it at 5 down the, and I got two pieces of paper here, straight down. And then these will be cut at 4. 4.5, I'm sorry, 4.5. So I think this will give me 6, which would be perfect because we're going to need 5 pieces for the waterfall and 1 to be the base to build on. So let me count up how many we have and I'll write that down for you. It is, get it in there, 4.5 and 1/2 by 5. Okay, so let me count up how many I have. There's 2 there, 2, 3, 4, 5. I have a couple extra. Okay, so that'll be our base, and those will just be scrap. All right. So we'll build on this little piece. And as you know, or if you don't know, I'm going to trim this waterfall. I just know it. As hard as I try, score at 4, by the way. You need 1/2 inch, so score at 4. As hard as I try to get it all straight and square, it just never seems to work out. And so I have found a way to compensate, and that's what I do about every time. So on your 4.5 side, at 4, I'm sure I will do it this time too. It just seems to be, maybe I'm too persnickety, but I really don't think so. I don't think anybody'd want unevenness. I don't know. You can tell me if you have better luck than I do with this, but I think it's a very easy way to make a crisp and clean waterfall. So one more. At 4. And we will build this. Okay, I'm going to score these really, or burnish really well. That helps. And I am going to build on the base because you can trim it down. And if this turned out to be straight, we would celebrate. But I know myself that well. All right, so I always build on the base because you can. If you did it right into the book and it came out crooked, I would be one unhappy person. So it's just too easy to do it like this. So just glue on the flap. Doing it on the base gives you the added benefit of having the side, because it's the same size, right? So you can sort of measure your sides and try to get it straight. And I do all those tricks, but I just don't have much luck. So always go back inside, make sure you have no residual glue that gets away from you. Sometimes that happens to me. So with your second one, I always say just get it pretty in the middle. I'm going to aim for the side and get it straight. Wouldn't that be amazing if that happened? But get it straight, and I can tell this one's not going to be right. Get it nice in here, no gaps here. I can always trim the side and see if you can tell that's over. See, just a little bit. It's not much, but it bothers me. So I found a way to fix that, and I just think it's very simple. And it's much less stress, right? There's no stress building a waterfall anymore because I know I add in that little bit of, what is it? You're taking off less than 1/4 inch. So I add that to my side and I just know I'm going to do it. So straight in there, pretty in the middle. That one looked good. I can't really believe I'm the only one that struggles with getting these straight. Nobody can cut all these pieces of paper and have them be exact. I just don't quite believe it. But that is pretty in the middle. There's glue right there. I don't know where that came from. Okay, and one more. Okay, when we lay it back over, see, I can tell. I don't know if you can see that, but that's just not good enough for me. That's over right there. Some of them are shorter. This one's longer. This one's longer. I just can't deal with that. So, if you have an X-Acto knife or a finger blade or whatever you've got, and a metal ruler or my Tim Holtz ruler, all I do is measure, get this the top of it straight on one of my blue lines on my mat. I line up on a line that's coming down. It makes it just easier. You don't have to. You can. This Tim Holtz ruler makes it very easy to measure, but I can also use the line. And I think I will do that. That all looks good. Move it up just a hair. You move it back a little bit closer to me so I can see it. Okay. I'm not going to use the blue line. It's taken off too much. Okay. So just got it measured up on my ruler. Take your blade and just several passes with light, even pressure. Don't try to force it. It does take several passes. And it's hardest right in the middle, right in here's where it was giving me angst, because that's where your heaviest glued edges are, right? So that's beautiful. Let's line this up, get it straight. And I'll just line up with my ruler. Get my ruler straight. Take off a little bitty bit. I haven't seen anybody else do this, and I just struggle believing that everybody makes perfect waterfalls, but maybe they do. Maybe they do. Okay, that's off. And now look, it is crisp and clean. And what did that take? 3 minutes? It was nothing, and it's beautiful. And you just have this little bit of mess. I think this is, that's the way I roll. Alrighty, so I will not put it into the book. Where's the page? If I were, I would put score tape all over the back, put your decorative paper on here, and then guide that for the middle. Let me show you how I made a closure for it. I grabbed a scrap. Sometimes I like the wider ones because you can get a bigger sticker or something. It doesn't matter. You could use, you know, that scrap. You could use, I think I'll use the wider one. I kind of like it. So I just put it in my scoreboard. Actually, let's just make a mark on here. So we wanted to come up, you know, halfway up. So I'm just going to make a mark down here. That's where I'm going to score. Move that to a line. And score. And fold. Let's check it again. Make sure I got the right end. Yeah, it's this end. Okay, so let's cut this off, right? We don't need all that. And we'll just leave me a little flap to glue down. That's how I do it. And I will glue it down. I'll show you how I did that. I did do it to the white paper, and I put my pattern paper on top of this flap. So I just stuck it in the middle, all the way down to the edge. And laid it down. Okay, so when you put your waterfall on there, that'll go down. How can I show you to do magnets? Magnets would come before, let me just talk you through it. Magnets would come before you do your papers, right? And what I would do, say this waterfall was stuck down, right? I would bring this flap back. I would line up with this flap, and I would put my two magnets right here and tape them down, and then get the magnets on top of those magnets, and then close this and push this down, transferring the magnets to the flap. And then when you pick the flap up, your magnets are on the bottom of that and the top of this, but it'll will stick, and then you can cover over with patterned paper. That's how I did that. Alrighty, let's build the cover. Okay, I'm cutting my chipboards. This one is 6.5 by 6.5 by, let me look and make sure, 7.5. Got my notes right there. What I was gonna say is when you cut that piece, you're gonna have this off right, because this is the last, and this is the same width as your spine. So my spine is 2 inches, so that's a good time to cut it. Make sure you're straight in here. I felt like my spine was wonked in the one I did. I've never had that happen before, but it seemed like it. You really couldn't tell, but that's straight. And then just cut your other one 7.5 by 6.5. There's a funny edge on that, on all of these. I don't know why, so I'm gonna turn it to the side. 7.5 by 6.5. To cover these chipboards, I'm going to take 3 pieces of 8.5 by 11, just put some glue down the side and join them together so we have enough length to cover our little book, our now even chipboards. Okay, so more glue on this side. Is that glue coming out? No, it's not. Come on, glue. Okay, so just lay it down. We've got plenty of paper. One thing I am going to do that I did is I'm going to lay my chipboards on here, or at least one of them, kind of like that, and I have a longer ruler here. Metal ruler, and I'm just going to take it and put it at the top of my chipboard right there, and take my X-Acto knife. You don't have to, you could cut it off with scissors, you don't have to be neat, but I kind of liked that it was just done, and it is neat. So I'm going to bring it on down and line it up and just go ahead and trim that off. All right, there we go, much cleaner. I'm going to put score tape on my chipboard. I just think I've tried it with glue, and I just think it's, you hear the glue is what I don't like. You hear, I mean, it takes it for, I don't like it. I'm just gonna use my score tape. So I'm just gonna put it all over every inch of the chipboard. determine my hinge width. It has to fit into our page, right? And our page is 7. So I'm going to cut this at 6.5 down the long way. It needs to fit into our page easily. And so I always do a test run. You know, there's your opening on the side. And yeah, 6.5 is good. All right, so I think we can get it all done. At least I did first time. There's another belly band. All right, so pull out your scoreboard. This is very simple, very, very simple. I use whole numbers and half numbers, and I just don't have time for eighths and sixteenths and three-fourths, and I just don't. So I started at 1.5. This will be the spot where you put this. This will be on the cover, right? And then before every page, you need a gusset, and mine are 1/2 inch. Okay, so you need a 1/2 inch to start with from your first mark. And pages are you need two 1-inch segments. So I'm going to go from 2 to 3 and from 3 to 4. Okay, that's one page right there. After every page, actually before and after every page, you need a gusset. So that's 1/2 inch. Now we're at 4.5, so go to 5.5 for your next page, 6.5 for the second part of that. There's your second page. Now you need your gusset of 1/2 inch. Now an inch, and 1/2 inch. And look, we have the same amount of paper on each end. Perfect. So when you fold it up, hoping that won't fall to the floor. Don't fall to the floor. Can you balance? Thank you. Just take your 1-inch segments and fold them together. It's very easy to see. Bend them both ways, both directions. This is your hinge. It's gonna needs to, you know, it's turn your pages. So there's your 1/2 inch gusset. Your next 2 1-inch segments, just fold them together. Fold them down. Fold them back that way. Okay, and your last one is right there. I just think holes and halves are so much easier to see. And just makes this so much easier. I was intimidated by hinges for years. Really, I was, and scared of them. And it's because they were like, score here, score here, score here, score here. And I'm like, I can't keep up. But when you do it in halves and holes, it's just easy. All right, so there's our hinges. Now we need to turn it over and put score tape in here. So where is my, got everything stacked up here. I'll use this. You just want to take it and put it on one side of your 1-inch segment. You don't need it on both of them. All right. Let me show you the easy way to see this. Let me use this. Okay, burnish that down. Let's just go ahead and take it off, and I'll show you how easy this is. Because we've pre-folded, your other 1-inch segment is just going to lay down, right? So I generally go through and put all my tape on first, but I'm just showing you how simple that is. Now on the other half, that's your 1/2 inch gusset right there. So on the other side of that, you're on your 1-inch segment. Just put your tape down. Let's go ahead and take this one off too, just to show you. You just peel it off, pull it forward. Okay, it is very simple. And then your last one, oh my gosh, my tape is getting crazy. Just go on the other side of that 1/2 inch gusset and put her down. Okay, so let's go ahead and take that one off too. Pull my tape back, see it's sticking over right there, and just lay it down. And then burnish it really well. And we have just built a hinge for a little album. Very, very simple, just like that. Let's put it in the book. And when you put the hinge in the book, what you want to do is get it in the middle of the spine. Actually, these two, where you want it in the middle of there, right? So just use your best judgment. You want to get it even top to bottom, and you want to try to get it straight. do the best you can. It is very subjective. All right, when I've got it where I think I want it, and I think that's generally straight, I'm going to lay it down, and I'm going to take my pencil and draw a line right on the side of that paper. Okay, now you got to put score tape all over the back of this, and you want your score tape to go in the same direction as your hinges. So your score tape has to go that way. You can ask me how I know that. That was horrible trying to get that spine in that book. It's just going the wrong way. It just was awful. Use my ruler. This wide stuff. Take a few pieces of this and fill in. I want to get my hinge completely covered in tape because this is, where did my little tool go? This is the lifeblood of your album. If it comes out, your pages are gone and, you know, you put too much hard work in it not to really pay attention to your hinge. Okay. So burnish that all down really, really well. Okay, now's where our line really comes in to help us. Okay, I'm gonna take off one piece of the tape. This is where I wished I'd have used littler tape because you don't want too much of that exposed. What you do, hold it with the hand with the tape, right, over here. Trust your line, come into your line, your tape is exposed. Watch your top and your bottom and just trust your line, get to it, and just lay it down. There, I think I got too close to the bottom that I did to the top. If I could undo that, I would. Be very careful when you're doing that. So let's pretend I got it in the middle. Let's take off the rest of our tapes, holding carefully to your hinge. And my tape is over here too, where I got it, it's just big tape. But just pull it kind of up and kind of just lay it straight down. And mine is not where I want it. This book is not for anybody. It's just a tutorial. But I really should have gotten it. If you can see, you have more room here than there. It would still work. It would still work. I'm not going to trash it, but it's not how it ought to be done. All right, now you have to score again. And I'm going to use my ruler for that. Just line up by the spine where you can see it down there. I'm going to use the bigger ball and tread lightly. I have pushed through this before, and that is not fun. So just give it a couple of light passes. Just hold everything still. And then I like to take the slanted ridge of my ruler and it just bends up. Beautiful. So same on this side. And take your slanted edge and just put it in there and boom, chakalaka. I cut two papers that are basically 6 1/4. See, I had that was written 7.5 by 6.5. So 7 1/4 by 6 1/4, and that will make that very tidy. So I'm just going to put that down, and this will make our album look better. Whoa, glue. I did clean out the tip again this morning. And I think it's going to work better. So I like to come to the outside edge. Pretty far out there. You do not want to cover that bending line right there, right? So just get it down. Makes everything nice and clean and tidy. Okay, I'm using the scrap from where I cut for the papers on the inside, and I'm just trimming it down to 4. And then, if you know me by now, you know I score first, cut later. So I'll score on that side, and we'll score on the bottom our 1/2 inch. And then we'll lay it in the book, fold this edge so we know exactly what we're working with, right? Put it down, and then I'm gonna make a mark, and right there is where I'm gonna score. Okay, I'm not going to put it down. As you can see, it fits very well. It doesn't impede our bending line or anything, but I would like to mat this first. But that's how you build the basic pocket. Then I would just put glue on it and just glue it right down. Probably have your pattern paper down there first. So in the other album, I had another pocket right here. So just make 2 at one time. And then let's create a flap for this, and that will be about everything I did for the album. Okay guys, I cut a piece for a flap that is about 6 inches wide and about 7.5 long. You're gonna turn it and score 1/2 inch. See a piece of where I marked on there, I'll erase that. And then we'll fold and put this in the book. And this would cover the pocket if we had put the pocket there. Let me pull this down, make sure you can see. But I'm going to go ahead and attach mine because I can do that and put it up near the top and still get my matting and everything in there. I'm just going to put it at the very, very top. Okay, and so when I come back to mat, I can just mat right over that flap, right? Okay, and pocket will be under there, and that's everything for flap. Let's skip pages and get those in the book. Okay, to put the pages in, you're gonna have to put score tape on your hinges. Sometimes I do it when it's in the album, sometimes I do it when I'm making the hinge, but it doesn't really matter. So just put it on, and I'm using 3/8. You don't want it to be too close down into there because your page has to be able to, you know, have a little free. You're not going to go all the way down with your page anyway. If you have yours decorated, make sure you have your front up and make sure that your pages are oriented in the right direction. This is the waterfall page that was on my front, so I'll go ahead and put that one on. First thing I do is a test fit. I just like to get it on there, wiggle it around, see how it, you know, just make sure. So take your tape off a little bit up here at the top, just about 1 inch or so, maybe 1.5 inches. Be wary of flaps. This one doesn't have a flap, but sometimes flaps can get in the way and impede and push those other hinges out of the way. And just get it on there. You want to get it level. You want to come down within less than 1/4, something like that, and just push when you got it down there. I'm leaving a little extra room here because my hinge is not in there straight, but it'll be just fine. So just hold it and push your tape. All right, then turn it over. Take your little pokey tool, hunt up in there for your tape, and just pull. You know, it's easier to put non-decorated pages in the book I can tell you that for sure right now. Okay, so here's your flips, right? These will be next. So they, we know that the flap opens to the left, so this is the right orientation for the page. Really wouldn't matter, but you know, take those things into consideration. Peel back your tape. Get that flap out of the way. Sometimes, see this, how this could catch on to it? I had problems with that when I was doing my album. So just go on there. Come down, make sure she's level in here, you know, and just push down. Okay, what is that on my glue probably? Go in and hunt for your tape. This is ever so much easier without your book decorated, but not as easy to decorate it once it's in here, that's for sure. Okay, so our last page goes like that. So let's do this. Okay, push down, peel your tape. Okay guys, I hope you've enjoyed this little process. If you have any questions, just leave them in the comments. And again, I just paper clipped that in there because I will decorate this and do something with it. Maybe make a little Christmas something or something, I don't know. But anyway, happy decorating of your album, and hope you've enjoyed the process. And thank you all new subscribers. You guys have a blessed day.